Async IO and multithreading in Python, irrespective of their relatively similar intent, they are two different things. And in this video, we are going to look into Async IO and understand the difference. Hello everyone, welcome to the video series on interesting topics of modern Python programming. And in this particular video, we are going to look into Python coroutines and Async IO. Coroutines, because you need to understand coroutines before you can work on Async IO. Now let's start with coroutines. What are coroutines? If you break this word, coroutines are co-routines. Co means cooperative, routines means function. So coroutines are nothing but cooperative functions. Any programming language for that matter, if it is supporting coroutines, it is supporting cooperative functions. Now how functions are cooperative? Now when you call a function, it executes all the things written in the function before returning back to the caller, right? Cooperative functions are such that it can return in between and resume from there, and that's how it cooperates with the caller. We are going to see one example, but let's look into this Python documentation. It says that coroutines can be entered, exited, and resumed at many different points. So one of the simple way of creating coroutines are using yield. So I'm creating a function called a function. It is printing before yielding 1, 2, 3, okay? And I am creating another function called B function. It is iterating over A function. So remember, any cooperative functions can be iterated through in Python. So what I'm trying to do over here is that I'm trying to print the value that is being returned from the function and then sleep for 1 second. What do you think will be the output when I call this particular function? Well, let's see. When I call this function, you can see that yielding 1 and then print, yielding 2 print, which means the control is transferred from one function to another function. Here what happens that when I'm calling a function, it is yielding 1 and control is now transferred back to the calling person or the function, sorry, and then it is printing. So you can see that back and forth things are happening. Now, why do we need cooperative functions? I have written that to make proper use of available resources. Now imagine a scenario. You are having a function which is waiting for user input. Python is having GIL, right? It's a global interpreter lock. So at any point of time, one thread of execution can happen. If you are not aware of GIL and multithreading in Python, I'll highly recommend you to go ahead and see my video. You can see a card over here about multithreading in Python. But don't need to stop. You can continue here. You'll be able to learn Async IO because I have also explained in context of the threads. Now, what you want is that by the time some function is waiting for user input, the control should come back and some other function can do something. This is where cooperation is required. Now, the difference between multithreading and cooperation, I will talk about that in a moment, okay? Now, let's see some examples. I've created a function called a function sleeps for 2 seconds and print. Similarly, B function sleeps for 2 seconds and print. Now, what will happen when I call C function? Okay, how much time it will take? It's an easy guess. It will take 4 seconds, right? Come, yes, it will take 4 seconds. Now, you know, this A function is sleeping, B function is sleeping. Something else can be done during that time, okay? And I have already talked about GIL. Now, the cooperation can only happen in Python only and only if you have IO bound tasks, not the CPU intensive tasks. Because CPU intensive tasks, if you are preempting in between, it will lead to trouble. It will be delayed, okay? Now let's create some threads, or two threads rather. I'm creating two threads over here and calling A function and B function in there. Now what will happen if I call thread function? How much time it will take? It's an easy guess. It will take 2 seconds because two threads are running simultaneously. Okay, now that's good. You know, we can achieve parallelism. What is the problem? Problem with threads is that you don't control threads. And even from the threads, the control cannot go here and there, right? The threads execute as per operating system. You don't have much control over it. And that's the reason you need async IO, because you have a control of when you want to call a, you know, IO bound function, how much you want to wait, and when you want to get back the result, okay? Now, async IO is supported in Python using a library called async IO, Okay, and the syntax is async await. Okay, so to use async IO, you need to import async IO, and I'm just checking about the loop, async IO loop, which is still running over here. Now, since this is Jupyter Notebook, that's why it is happening. If it is not running, the loop is not running, you need to call async IO.run. And most likely when you create your code in a PyCharm or Visual Studio Code, you will call that function by calling async IO run. Okay. Now, what's the change in syntax? It's very similar. You just need to prefix any function with async and call that function using await. So let me create an async function. You can see an async function. Now we need to use async io.sleep to make sure that we, you know, get the async behavior. Now, the first line of test function, second line of test function. So what will happen if I call the function? Nothing. The first line will get called. After 1 second, say last line will get called. Now, this is all about syntax. Now let's go ahead and create a function which is taking an input and sleeps for 2 seconds. And let me call this function twice. So I have created an async function which is calling two functions twice, and it is calling this print text function with first print, second print. Now, how much time it will take if I call these two functions? Any guess? Sorry, call two functions. The function name is call two functions. It took 4 seconds. And this is where most of the people get surprised. They think that, okay, I used async IO. Why I'm still getting 4 seconds? How it is different from, you know, what I was getting earlier? It's not different from what you were getting earlier. What async await does is that it enables your function to be run asynchronously. Okay, so to run it asynchronously, you have to create task. So in here I am creating task. Okay, async IO create task, and I am calling this print text function or with two types. Okay, with, you know, different parameters. And what will happen if I call this function now? Any guesses? You can see that the time taken is printed immediately, and then first print, second print is printed. Don't think it's 5 seconds. It's not 5 seconds. It just, look here, it's very small amount of time, 0.01 or something like that. Okay. So this print gets executed first because I am printing is called after some sleep, right? So you are sleeping for 2 seconds, you means this function, and then it is printing. And this is where the async behavior comes into picture, where this gets executed while everything else is doing its work. Now you might be thinking that, okay, what if I want to wait for multiple tasks? I don't want my, you know, main program to end, right? For that, you can wait on task. Okay, here I have created another function which is waiting on the task. And if I call this particular function, what do you think the amount of time it will take? It will take 2 seconds, very similar to threads, but here you have control, right? So this is the meaning of async IO and how you can make use of it. There is another way. If you want to create more than one task, you can create something called task group. So here I have created task group with the function. I can create any number of tasks within a task group. I think saying any number will be wrong because everything has its own limit, and I don't know the limit over here, but you can easily create, you know, whatever is required for a normal production code. So if I create task group, the, you know, await on those tasks is automatic. So you don't have to write await one, task two, and task n. Okay. And it will give you the same behavior where it will take 2 seconds. Okay. But there is one catch. This task group looks very good. It's available only from 3.11 onwards. It is not available even if you are using Python 3.7, 3.8, 3.9, 3.10. Okay. So that's all about Python, async IO, and coroutines. I do hope and believe that I was able to explain this concept in the easiest possible way. Thank you all. Thanks for watching. We will meet again. Until the next time we meet, good day, goodbye. You take care.